Hi, my name is Joseph Ally. Welcome to my channel. And today I want to talk about getting rid of competition or third parties completely. This is a topic I'm asked time and time again, and I've never formally addressed it. And so I wanted to take the time to express how to do it and what kind of mindset to have in order to manifest the removal of any competition or third parties, all in all. And another thing is, this is, I believe, my 100th video, my 100th publicly released video. And so I'm so grateful for this. I mean, the only reason for my explosive growth is because of you. And so together, I'm absolutely honored to be on this journey. And I'm so grateful that you're joining me here now. And so before we get started, I'd like to say definitely subscribe to my channel for information and exact laser targeted techniques on exactly how to manifest whatever you want. And so with that said, let's jump right into it. So competition or third party, right? A lot of times this topic comes up in the case of a specific person. So you have an ex, or you have someone that you're after, but there's another person that either you're suspicious that they are involved with that person, or there's absolutely definitely someone involved with that person. And on the other hand, the idea, a lot of times this comes in with business, and that there's competitors, or that there's people, or people trying to stomp you out or do anything at all costs to make sure that you don't succeed. Now, this happens in all aspects of life. It happens in community. It happens with personal growth. It happens with business. It happens with relationships. It happens with government. And so the first thing, and this is kind of the key here, is the idea of competition, the idea of a third party. If that idea is embedded in your mind, then it's a very good sign of a scarcity mindset. Now, my story personally is my entire life, right? I mean, I struggled a lot in my life, and I'm sure a lot of you have as well. That powerlessness that drives us to look for the art or craft of manifesting. I mean, I always wanted to start a business. I always, you know, had girlfriends or wanted girlfriends, but there seemed to be always something in the way. And then I had my parents telling me, you know, be careful, or you got to watch out for this person, or the competition is fierce. And oftentimes you'll hear this a lot when you have big dreams, you know, the protective, you know, be careful, stick with the safe road, the road traveled more. But here's the thing, the subconscious mind manifests anything it wants to, and all things are absolutely possible, period. And so whatever it is that's fixed in our mindset will become true. Period. And that is just the way that the world works. And I'm sure that you've tested this by now. And if you haven't, and you haven't heard me say this, testing it is the number one crucial thing to master manifesting. It will, you'll be able to reflect back on your testing or your data. And no matter what anyone says, or no matter what your ego says, you'll always have that proof that this is true. But the reason this is so important is that if the idea of the competition is in your mind, it will begin to show up everywhere. Now, as I said, in my past, I was basically screwed. I mean, I just did not grow into a mindset of abundance or freedom. All along in my mind, I was riddled or raked with ideas of competition, suppression, hard work. Everything is hard. Everything's a battle. And the problem with this is that it becomes true. It becomes true. It multiplies and multiplies. And everything I was doing, I would always be met with sheer resistance and force. There would always pop up a competitor, right? My big thing was always business. A competitor would pop up. Someone would release the product. I would always find. Now, here's the thing. It's not only that people appear there, my mind will make it true too. So I will seek it out. And that's the problem with competition. And so here's the simple solution. And I'm going to read you a verse after this, but the simple solution is to rid your mind completely of the idea that there is competition. Now, the truth is that all things exist now. So there already exists a version of you somewhere that is the person that you want to be. So you don't have to take anything away from anybody, and no one has to take anything away from you. And in fact, when I rid that from my mindset, it actually stopped happening. There ended up being no competition with whatever it was, because everyone independently can get whatever they want, no questions asked. And so, but if we are in our imaginal acts, for example, imagining with the competitor in mind, then we're actually fixing them into place, because all things exist in the imagination. And when we imagine, we fix it into reality. There may be a time frame between that, and you may not even notice this because it's been with you for so long. But when and if you change your mindset, you will see the results in this world reflecting your mindset. So there's a verse in the Bible, and it says, "Whoever hath, to him it shall be given, and he shall have more abundance. But whoever hath not, from him shall be taken away, even that which he seemeth to have." That may sound like a cruel, disturbing verse, but it's what it's talking about, and it seems to not even make sense. It's like, well, that's cruel and evil and whatever, but it doesn't even seem to make sense. But if you look at the mystical meaning of it, the meaning that I've been trying to get across time and time again, now the 100th video of trying to elaborate this, it's talking about your imagination. It's talking about what is impressing the subconscious mind. Now, until I figured this out, what that meant, I had no real indication as to what to change. And the other verse says, "As a man thinketh in his heart, so is he." So if you combine these two verses, what it's telling you is that whatever's in your imagination, whatever beliefs you have, the competition, the third party, the girl you want gone, the guy you want gone, if you keep those in your imagination, that means you have it. Because the truth, the source of truth, is in the imagination. So again, if I am imagining or thinking or worrying or racking my brain on this third party or this competition, well then in my imagination, according to my imagination, I have that, right? I'm thinking about it. My thoughts create reality, and therefore I have that. And if I have that, it's manifesting outward, and I will get more of that. Each seed that we plant in our mind by imagining or thinking or feeling or believing will sprout a tree, and the tree itself will also drop thousands of seeds. And so it becomes increasingly important to make sure that we're not focusing on anything that you don't want. Because you ever heard of the term, it says, whatever you focus on grows? It's exactly that. Whatever's in your imagination, whatever you allow into your consciousness, will continuously grow larger and larger. So as an applicable step, and you can do this right now, and I would love for you to do this right now, we can take a couple seconds to do it, is imagine what you want. So for instance, say you have there's a third party involved, or perhaps you don't even know if there's a third party involved, right? What we do now is pretend that that is not even an obstacle. Because here's the thing, if we only focus on the end, then whatever needs to happen in order for the end to happen will happen automatically. We never need to focus on something being removed. So for instance, if my goal is to become, you know, a billionaire, but in my mind I have all these ideas of people that are competing against me and what have you, then there's going to be a big problem, because there will be competition that arises, and it will grow and grow and grow, as I'm sure some of you have seen. Now, there's a story that I talked about a while ago, and it's one of my friends. There was a man who appeared on the scene when he was after a woman. Now, he saw him with her and he freaked out. And then when he was thinking about it, it kept growing and growing and growing, and it got worse and worse and worse. Even when he would try to imagine that third party, even if it was or wasn't, in his mind it was, and so it became one apparently, when he would try to imagine, it would not leave his mind, and so therefore it grew. Now, when he took a break, when he stopped thinking about this man entirely and even stopped imagining for a short while, all that negative stuff vanished, and he then completely focused only on the end, and then everything got remarkably better. And so what I'd like for you to do is think of what you want without thinking about what you don't want. If you're thinking about what you don't want, it's just like, so there's the other verse that says, let the weak man say, I am strong. I am strong, not I am not weak. And why is it phrased like that? Because I am not weak, you're thinking about someone being weak. And if you're thinking about it, it will manifest and grow larger and larger and larger. And so think about what you want, not what you don't want. If you're after a person, only imagine them. Disregard anything else entirely. In fact, you're supposed to go after the end. And if you're after the end, then why would you ever think about the competition anyway? And that's just to bring it all full circle. You want to imagine the end. You never want to think about the obstacles. If you are having trouble, you never think about the trouble. You only think about the positive solution to your desires. And if you do this, and if you only imagine the successful end over and over, feel it real, saturate your mind with it, when the time comes and the seed is planted after you imagine, first of all, it's planted instantly and it will begin to grow, but there will be nothing related to any competition because remember, there's infinite abundance. Everyone can have everything. You don't need to remove something from someone. In fact, that mindset will cause a lot of things to be removed and it'll cause pain and misery and anxiety. And we want to transcend these thoughts. We want to imagine the end. We don't want to think about the competition whatsoever. And in successfully doing so, we will absolutely manifest the end in a perfect way. And the same goes with business. The same goes with anything at all. There's nothing or no one that can ever hold you back. It's impossible. It's impossible. And so just think about that, right? Take the time now, take 3 seconds right now and imagine what you want only in the tense as if it's done and there's no obstacles in the way. 1, 2, 3. That's 3 seconds. That's all it takes. It's a quick thing to impress something upon the subconscious mind and for it to be expressed, right? Some things happen instantly, some things take a little while. But either way, if you do it in the right way, if you get it past your awareness into your subconscious mind, past the gatekeeper into your subconscious mind, then you will experience it. I've tested this thousands and thousands of times. My viewers have tested it thousands and thousands of times. My clients have tested this thousands and thousands of times. And so put it to the test. Feel it real. Imagine the end. There's no such thing as competition. And in fact, that's an assumption that I continuously use there's no competition, but instead I phrase it in a way like, I always receive what I want. All things come to me easily and effortlessly, never mentioning the negative thing. Otherwise that thing will grow. And so I just want to let you know, if you want to know more fundamentals and techniques like this, I'm going to give you a video right now. Definitely check that out and stay tuned for more. Thank you so much for watching.